Good evening, I'm Sean Green with the Cbc Sports. Well, Barbados has been relegated back to Zone Group 2 of the Davis Cup Americas after going down 4-0 in their tie against Ecuador at the Tennis Center in Wilde today. Entering the final day 2-0 down, Barbados suffered a two-sets defeat in the doubles match to lose the tie. CBC's Kamal Haynes reports on that game.
The pair of Darian King and Hayden Lewis in the far court had a positive start against Gonzalo Escobar and Diego Hidalgo, taking the first game. But Ecuador responded off the serve of Hidalgo, taking the second game with a powerful left-hand drive too hot for Lewis to handle. Barbados regained the lead in Game 3 after being deuced at 40-all. Lewis with the soft touch to give the home side the advantage, then returns with a good serve as Hidalgo forces the ball into the net. Ecuador regrouped well and started to show consistency, bridging the gap between Barbados. Hidalgo with a powerful backhand beating King down the right. They would press on to take the first set 6-4, here denying Lewis and King the point, finding the answers to every question presented by the Barbados pair to eventually win the point after Lewis hits it out. Second set and Barbados faced with a must-win situation. Lewis with his powerful serve sees Barbados up in the first game. This set was more evenly contested between the two teams, with both winning game for game to keep a close grip on each other. Here Gonzalo hits it out long. Barbados looked determined to carry it all the way, Lewis producing two smashes, with the latter giving Barbados a 4-3 lead. Fast forward to the tiebreak after both teams are locked at 6 games apiece, and Ecuador proved they wanted the victory more, sweeping the tiebreak 7-love to win the match 2-love, taking the tie against Barbados. Kamal Haynes, CBC Sports.
And in the final game of the day, the reverse singles Diego Hidalgo of Ecuador sealed the deal with a 6-love, 6-1 win over Xavier Lawrence. While the West Indies women's captain Stephanie Taylor believes it will not be an easy task when her side takes on the South African women in the third round of the ICC Women's Championship at Kensington Oval tomorrow. She was speaking at the Oval earlier today after her side's final preparation ahead of the first ODI.
Well, I think he's basically adapting. I believe that if we could, you know, play at home, we should play better than, you know, South Africa, seeing that we're playing at home. But I know that saying that, it's not going to be an easy series. Last time we met South Africa, they had the upper hand, but you know, that is all in the past, and you know, we want to push forward, control what we can, which is, you know, first game tomorrow.
Well, the Windies women lost their last two encounters against the South African women, and Taylor says that her side will be aiming to flip the script.
There's a score to settle, but you know, looking at South Africa team, they have been evolving, they have improved over the last, you know, few years, and I think they're still improving, you know, seeing that they have, you know, some changes to their team, young girls who look good as well. The last two games that we played against them in the World Cup wasn't the best of, you know, games we had. I think one of the games they bowled us out for 60 something, and I'm not sure in the other game, but you know, it was a low total, and you know, they got the best of us.
Our play bowls off at 9:30 a.m. Well, Sajagoa Life UWI has extended its lead at the top of the BCA Elite Division standings after a comprehensive innings and 27-run victory. And this came over Home Improvement Hardware Supplies Maple at Trent's on day two of the fifth series. Scores: UWI 276 for 3 with skipper Jonathan Carter getting 102, and Maple 74 and 175. Scores in the other matches: at Paragon, ICBL Empire 174 and 87 for 7 against the BDF, who made 220. Over at Dells Road, Counterpoint Wanderers 167, Wilde 255 for 8 and 108 without loss. At Rice's, Queen Resort St. Catherine 160, Gladiola 208 and 198 for 8. And at Queen's Park, the Barbados Youth 195 and 85 for 4, Spartan 238. In more cricket news, the Trinbago Knight Riders will meet the Guyana Amazon Warriors in tomorrow's final of the Hero Caribbean Premier League after eliminating Chris Gayle's St. Kitts and Nevis Patriots in the semi-finals last night. Playing at their Brian Lara Academy, the home team posted 165 for 6, with Brendan McCullum top scoring with 43 off 26 balls. The Patriots could only make 145 for 8 in their 20 overs, with Devon Thomas getting 35 and Fawad Ahmed taking 3 for 13.